Okay, so let's find out. Whoa!
Jen, do you want to do the intro? All you got to do is say howdy everyone from Long Haul.
No. I want to show you something.
Okay, well, I have to do the intro, though. You want to do the intro, Galvin? No. Say howdy everyone from Long Haul.
Hi, you. Go. Oh.
That was pretty good. All right. Well, as Galvin said, howdy everyone from Long Haul. This is the updated video tour on May 5th, I think, 2016.
Daddy,
so Jen wants to show us something. Do you want to show us the new jungle gym?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, this jungle gym that we got for free on the side of the road. And I just put it up and reinforced it and with some poles and stuff. And Genevieve is very excited about that. And, yeah, Galvin was pretty excited about it, too. He actually, we put a bunch of bark down there, which is a good thing because he actually fell off of it not too long ago. But careful, kids. Okay, I'm going to go show some other things. Anyway, there's we moved the trampoline. The trampoline used to be right here, and this was originally cleared for an extension of the garden. And we've kind of decided at this point that we're probably going to plant some apple trees here. That direction is roughly south that way. And this is like kind of a south west, or sorry, northwest slope here. So anyway, we're going to, rather than fill in a bunch to make it flat and stuff, we're going to try to... Jen wants to show the trampoline. Yeah, well, anyway, we can see the trampoline, but if you kids jump on it, I'll come film some more. And then Amelia is working on the garden that we just, well, this has been our garden for a while, but we just kind of outlined it into more of a rectangle, so it was this really weird shape before. Oh, yeah, and we took down the garden fence, and there used to be, like, a woodshed there that was this super, super crappy woodshed that I built, like, I don't know, 5 years ago, and it was all tilty and horrible and kind of in the middle of our garden. So yeah, we're probably, this is going to be our garden space, this kind of outlining that Amelia is doing here. It's about 50 foot by, one of our garden spaces, 50 foot by 13 feet. And Genevieve's jumping on the trampoline over there. And over here will be orchards, as I was mentioning, just because it's kind of a northwest facing slope, I figure, but it's really sunny, so I figure apple trees will do fine there. Anyway, there's the house, and for some reason I think it's getting blurry right now, but yeah, and more play stuff, fun stuff for kids. The slide, of course, I think, well, we've had that last year. This is new since the last tour. This is the screen porch extension thing that I milled all the wood for this and framed it up last summer. And yeah, it's got two doors, and yes, it's somewhat of a luxury, but actually a necessity as well. Because we have our freezers out here, and in the winter we run solar, so we're off grid, so we need our freezers to be in an unheated space during the winter, because we don't have them on during the winter because we don't have enough power. So anyway, this is, and then we store wood in here in the winter too. Yeah, and one of our freezers is actually a refrigerator right now, because we have this little cool conversion kit thing you get off eBay. Which is way more energy efficient for running things like solar, off-grid, and all that. There's our other door over there. Here's our door. This is the Hobbit door that goes into the house. And, yeah. And so I finally finished this room, which, with some really nice Brazilian cherry hardwood flooring that I got for less than $1 a square foot off of Craigslist. And it was just a really small amount, so it was perfect. Then some tile I got for free, and yeah, anyway, I got, you know, maybe a couple bucks per square foot on the floor after all the materials. And yeah, all these boards I milled up. This whole extension cost around $1,500 to build, including the insulation, which we used that recycled denim stuff because I hate fiberglass. I think it's really disgusting. We have a futon in here, so we're sleeping in here, and the kids are also sleeping in here, and this room has, like, it doesn't look like much, but it has vastly improved our lives here. The tile entryway is really nice. Sleeping down here instead of going up into our tiny little loft is really nice. More than anything, Amelia now has hers and all the kids' clothes actually in our house now. So we're able to, you know, not have to go in and out all the time to our storage. So that's a really big deal. And yeah, we have a little more space in here now too. We reversed the staircase. It used to kind of come out this direction. Staircase. I guess that's more of a ladder. Anyway, there's the Baker's Choice wood stove. It's still doing awesome for us. Yep. Not too much else has changed in here, except for up here, we now have a library instead of a bedroom. And yeah, this is about 4 feet tall at the peak or so. So, yeah, you can't even stand up in here. You got to kind of crouch down. But the kids love it, and Amelia loves it, and got the little sewing machine there too. And then I got all my crap piled up over here, including some things I have to put away soon. I've been working on cleaning these pans. These are what we use for boiling down maple sugar. That's what I'm working on today, cleaning them up, getting the char off of them, and the scorched syrup off of them, and such. Anyway, moving right along. The other really, oh yeah, we got this new deck, so you can step here in the winter and stomp your feet off, and snow falls down in there, and it's great, so you don't track as much snow in. And what's going on, Jen?
I want to sled down the slide.
You want to sled down the slide? Oh yeah, this is a new game that Genevieve just figured out about. Can you do it all by yourself, or do you need my help?
Sure.
Why don't you get the sled up there? Where's the sled? Ask Mommy where the sled is. I'm not sure where the sled went. Anyway, I'm going to go look at some other stuff, and then I'll come check you out going down the, once you get the sled up there. So yeah, we have a couple new wood sheds over there. I built that one two years ago, and then those were built last year at our work party. Yeah, nothing too exciting, just really quickly built in like less than a day. This is our new... This used to be where I had a giant pile of junk and logs and all kinds of stuff. And now it's a garden. It looks a lot nicer. It's a vast improvement walking out our door and seeing a garden instead of a pile of junk and logs and building materials and such. All right, Genevieve found the sled, so she's going to go down the slide with the sled right now. But, oh, careful there, Gugu. Yeah. So, yeah, it's kind of in the shape of a heart. It's kind of like a sort of a high, it's more or less a terrace. You know, it's a slope here, so... We haven't planted anything where the straw is yet, but we got some herbs planted back there, transplanted. So, yeah, Jen is going to go down this slide with the sled. Okay. Okay, that looks a little bit sketchy, but ready?
Yeah.
A little bit sketchy, but super fun, right? Yay, okay. Anyway, so another big new thing.
Can you take a tour of the trampoline?
Yeah, well, yeah, you go jump on there. I'll be over there in a second. I'm going to show them the chickens. You want to show them the chickens? Oh, the chickens were, they were all right in front of the house, and I don't know where they just went right now. They're, hear them scratching around. Oh, there they are. So we converted the goat cabin to a chicken coop. And now we have 10 hens and a rooster, and which is really, really nice because we don't have to go to town for eggs anymore. It's pretty amazing. Like endless supply of eggs. And they're just kind of, we let them out during the day and they scratch around. And, oh yeah, we moved this cold frame over here, so we got some plants started in there. And yeah, this is, so I put a human-sized door onto the... goat cabin here, which we didn't have before, which was really super annoying because it was, yeah, we had to like go through this tiny, now this is a nesting box. One of the hens is actually in the nesting box, but that used to be the door, the only door back there behind that gate thing. And yeah, the old hay loft thing serves perfectly as a roost. We've also got this hanging water dipper thing for them to feed with, and then this no waste, less waste sort of feeding system thing
Daddy, you can find
plants for on the internet. Okay, stay out of here,
look,
kids.
Look, I found that.
Oh, you found the club. That's awesome. That's the club that I made for you guys. So, yeah, we just leave the door open during the day, and We had him in there for a few weeks after getting him, so because there was still snow when we got him. So they're pretty homed in, and then this is the nesting box, so we don't even have to go in to get the eggs. We just they pretty much all lay their eggs in here, and this hen's gonna be a little annoyed, but oh, sorry. Okay, I'll give you some privacy. Hopefully I didn't catch feathers there. All right. Anyway, and it's Genevieve's job to get the eggs, right, Jen?
Yeah.
So you love getting the eggs, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome.
Do you wanna get the can I do
anyway, that's so we just transferred the walking onions. What?
Can I do the rest of the tour?
No, but you can come along for the rest of the tour. So here's the walking onions. We just transferred them. We just tilled up this new ground. This used to be kind of part of our driveway, but now it's going to be gardens. We have another garden outlined there and one that I'm working on tilling right now there. We have the raised beds, and we built all these raised beds last year, so we're actually going to hopefully grow some vegetables this year for the first time. We're going to plant strawberries here and strawberries over there, and the raised beds are going to have a bunch of annual vegetables. And yeah, that is a cool trick, Jen. So yeah, here's the sort of, I don't know, side view of the house. We've got some water catchment systems going on there. We've got more water catchment on the other side. There's our washing machine for doing laundry when we have plenty of water and plenty of sunshine in the summer only, of course. And yeah, there's
Daddy,
some barrels.
Oh yeah.
And this is the
you forgot to show the swing, that big swing over there.
You're right, I did. Why don't you go down there and I'll film you in a second. I'm gonna go in here first. So this I built this a long time ago, and this 2 years ago, and this last year. So this is the I still got to do doors and stuff. I'm going to make like sliding doors on this thing. But this is about a 30 by 30 pole barn now at this point. And you can see as the light adjusts. So this half I built like 4 years ago. This half I built 3 years ago. And it's all with wood from the land. And milled or unmilled, as you can see with the round logs. I did most of this before having a mill. And then this half is the new storage wing. Oh yeah, the other wing I built 2 years ago. You can't see, it's behind that wall. We can go in there, but there's just a bunch of junk in there. But this is my new storage wing, which I'm like my lumber rack and all kinds of materials that I've been collecting for very cheap or free windows and lots of windows kind of cataloged. Now I can actually get to all this stuff. I just had it in piles before. Now it's like, oh yeah, I want this window. That's this size. I can see everything. It's amazing being organized. So there's all the doors. They're organized. Kind of. I got the inspiration from the ReStore for doing this sort of cataloging system of organization. And there's our poles and stakes and stuff and random little bits of wood organized by size and type of wood, at least somewhat organized. Excuse me. Amelia's gardening stuff. This is Amelia's side. It's really nicely organized, and that's like the kind of catch-all back there. And we have bikes and other stuff. I don't know. We have lots of stuff in here. Hi. Oh yeah, and then here's the swing that we just... Yeah, this is really exciting. And the chicken's just running up and down the hill, scratching around, looking for bugs and whatever else they eat. And then there's the swing. And I bet you kids are waiting for me to push you, aren't you? This is our awesome, awesome web swing thing that my mom bought for the kids for Christmas. And it's super, super fun when you go, woo! Woo-hoo!
I almost bumped the tree!
You almost bumped the tree? No, you didn't come that close. Woo! Hold on tight. Right? Okay, so this is really nice because we can actually see the kids from like all the things that we have to play on, the slide and the swings and this swing and pretty much everything we can see from the house. Careful, don't do that, Jen. That's making... Okay, I'll push you again. This is a little shelter that Neely and the kids built last year, which got a little fire pit and it's like a little you know, lean-to type of shelter with a little hole there. And yeah, and so we can see that from the this from the windows down up there.
That's
right. We built it with Jenna the grown-up. Did you stub your toe again? Okay, be careful when you're walking around barefoot. So down here, since we're already down here, I'll just go ahead and show the sugar bush. And a lot of the rest of this tour might be kind of boring for, I don't know. I mean, probably most of my tours are boring to begin with anyway, but especially for folks who have already kind of watched like some of my tours, like they seem, I mean, they're probably pretty repetitive, I would imagine. I don't really go through the old ones before I do the tour. So I probably showed this before, but maybe you can see it a little better. Here's where we boil, which is kind of at the bottom of our, it's all sugar maples up there. So we get all our, you know, from by where the kids are playing on the swing, that's like where we collect all our sap. And then we just kind of wind our way down here, and the last couple maples are right here. And there's more maples down there, but not very many. So yeah, here's the sugar bush boiler. And yeah, I put the steam table pans in this thing. I have another video about that. I'm not going to go on about this very, very long, because you've probably already seen that video. It's like my most popular video. But okay, so the sugar bush. Yeah, and I set up this a couple years ago, just some scrap roofing and some poles. And it's going to have to be torn down sometime. It's only temporary, but whatever. More wood. Lots of wood. Okay, I'm going to take a little break here for a second. Wait, okay, go ahead and sing.
These noises are just from the background, now, nah, nah. These noises are just from the background, now, nah, now. These noises are just from the silly but silly background, now, nah, now.
I think that's a Genevieve George original. What do you think? Did you make that up?
Yeah.
All right, I love that song. Okay, kids. You want to walk to Damien's teepee now?
Yeah.
All right, we're down at the sugar bush still, and we're walking this way to Damien's teepee. And Jen is going really, really fast because she's a super, super fast girl. I don't even know if I can keep up with her. And then Gugu's just lagging behind just a little bit. Are you barefoot, Goo? Oh, my goodness. Here, I'll just carry you. You're barefoot? Yeah, you got no shoes on. Here, I'll carry you. Oh, you're getting heavy, little guy. Yeah. That's okay. Anyway, we'll just cruise down over here. Whoops. That's the wrong button. Okay, and Jen is waiting for us. This is sort of a trail that I made a few years ago, and I needed a big tree, so I just kind of slashed my way through mostly brush to get to this big tree that I cut down over here, and made all the siding for the workshop out of that one tree. So yeah, that's actually the only live tree I've cut, I think, for most of the milling I've done. You are really strong, Jen. There's that big spruce tree that I cut. Yeah, most of the spruces that I milled for the siding of our house and the siding of, or the paneling of the house have been deadfalls, just spruces that I found in the woods that blew over, but were still not rotted or, you know, blown over like that year or something. So here we are at Damon's teepee. Yeah, and he's got a floor now, too. Which is great. He built a little pallet floor for himself. And he put in a stove, an actual stove with stovepipe and all that. He had a stove before, but no stovepipe. Nope, Damien's not home. So we're just going to walk on through.
Can I look in there?
No, you can't look in there. That's his house. So, yeah, and then we got Damien did a little bit of clearing of the brush throughout here. I think he plans the garden in the sunny spot here. It's looking pretty nice right now, although he needs to clear a few of those maples out. Those are going to shade it out. Yeah, and then he did some brush clearing down there, so the view is kind of improved. You can't really tell, you know, but anyway, that's kind of, that whole valley is pretty much our property, up to almost the ridge that you can see over there.
Just in my imagination.
Hi.
Yeah. That's interesting. Then watch your step through these. There's a lot of pokies right there. Okay. Oh, you have sandals on now. That's good. So yeah, there's Damien's hide tanning area, and there's his pallet storage woodshed thing, which I'm actually pretty impressed with. It took him a while to build it, but he did a really great job on it. And built it for almost nothing. I think he put like $25 into that or something. Maybe 30. An egg?
It's a rock that looks like an egg.
Oh yeah, looks a little bit like an egg. It's kind of flat though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. So we're leaving Damienville, Damienland, whatever you want to call it, and entering back in. Why don't you leave them there, Jen? They're supposed to be there. That's where Damien wants them. Here's Josiah's fire pit that he made when him and his family are staying. Okay, Goo, you're getting heavy, so I'm going to put you down now. What do you think about that? Is that okay?
Yeah.
You can get back from here now. Figured you might have had a little trouble keeping up with us before, but it's pretty much flat land from here. And this has been here for 3 years now, since Josiah and Christy and family, Tober and Koa, were here. They built this place in about three weeks or so, and it's just framed with balsam poles, small diameter balsam poles, mostly that he draw knifed all of them. He was going out and harvesting when there was like 4 feet of snow too. It was pretty crazy. And shoveled out this site and built this thing, and yeah, the beautiful spiral staircase that is the main highlight of this part of the tour here. And we put in a floor sometime, maybe 2 years ago. I don't really remember at this point. But yeah, this is it's a temporary structure by nature. It has no foundation. It's made of balsam poles that are sitting around on the ground. But, you know, it's served us as a storage shed, and we've had a few people stay in it for various amounts of time.
Look,
right now, it's just a storage shed for the most part.
Christy?
No, that's our stuff.
Oh.
Yeah. Anyway, we're going to go on to the sawmill shed.
Oh, I see a fake egg up here.
Okay. Well, I'm moving on along.
No, wait for me.
Okay. I'll wait for you kids right out of here by the sawmill shed. So then right here we have the sawmill shed. And, oh yeah, Nate was here until the beginning of last winter. And then he left and he's looking for land in a different part of the state right now. He said he's getting ready to, he's got it narrowed down to a couple pieces of land, but he was staying with us for about a year and, you know, looking for land around here and different places, and decided he didn't want to live right around here. But anyway, there's the sawmill shed with a bunch of boards and otherwise partially milled logs and such laying around. Oh, you okay, Goo? Okay, Jen, did you steal his ball? You go give him his ball right now. Go give him his ball. Go give it to him. He had it first. Okay. Give it to him. He had it first, Jen. So this is the decorations of the sawmill shed. It's a whole bunch of saws that I got mostly for $1 for like 30 something saws at an auction. Hey, don't climb on that. Don't climb on that. Get down. Get down right now. That side is definitely not totally stable, so don't do that. Don't climb on the wood here. Okay. Yeah, a whole bunch of wood, as I was saying. Log arch. There's the sawmill and the saws.
Very nice.
And yeah, nobody else wanted these saws, so it was like $1 at this auction. There's Nate's birch bark canoe. He's coming back for that sometime, I assume. I don't know. There's a big log. And yeah, that's, anyway, there's the house back over there. So we kind of did a loop around down. And yeah, over to the new building site or gardens or whatever. You kids hanging out there? Are you going to go to the raspberry garden? So yeah, I was able to do a little bit more logging this year. Pull out some more cedar logs from the bog down on the bottom of our 60 acres. Yeah, this is the that will eventually be our home site over in there. And this is some gardens that we've been working on. And this was all just brush. You couldn't even walk through here. It was just brush and trees and just wooded, super brushy area. So, yeah, we built a bunch more raised beds. There's a raised bed. There's another one. There's two more behind it. There's another one on the side there. This is a hugel bed that we made last year. So yeah, we have yet to really grow anything in any of these, but it's this is going to be the big year because we did a lot of infrastructure and prep work before. And
you forgot we planted some blueberries in there.
That's right. I'll tell about the blueberries in a second. This is something. I'm not sure. That's something. That's an apple tree. That's an apple. Oh no, wait. That's not an apple tree. That's an apple tree. Yep. That's an apple tree that got ripped partially in half by a bear last year, unfortunately. But anyway, it's still alive, we hope. And that's a, oh yeah, that's a currant bush behind it, because they go well together, I guess. That's a currant bush and an apple tree. And these are a bunch of blueberries here. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I think there's going to be one more, and then Millie's gonna plant like 16 more blueberries in those rows. All those stakes there represent where there'll be more blueberries. And then that's all raspberries back there on those trellises or whatever you call those stick thingies. Yeah, and we're gonna plant, we've got some more prepared spots for apple trees here. We dug this and fertilized it and limed it and did all in that spot and kind of made sort of a terrace there. And that's another plant of some sort that I'm not sure what it is. And that's, yeah, another apple tree is going to go there. And here's the swing that Tori built that I'm not terribly impressed with, but that branch was kind of just crying out for a swing to be there. So yeah, I guess it works. I don't know. Might have to do something with that someday. So yeah, eventually our house will hopefully be here. And this is like, we're kind of like looking south right now, that direction. And then we have this, yeah, why don't you just push yourself for a little bit. We have this, there's some more logs for the sauna. This is kind of a drop right here. It probably drops like, I don't know, at least 15, maybe 20 feet down into there. I eventually want to build a barn / workshop where the second story is a workshop and the first story is a barn, and you could have we'll have a drawbridge, or maybe not, some kind of bridge going out into the second story. It'll be pretty cool. And then eventually down there, we did some brush clearing down in that area, and we'll eventually have either more gardens or pastures or orchard or something down that way. So that's all long ways off. Yeah. But, we're making progress little bits here and there. And yeah, kids, I'm gonna go over here now. There's the raspberries again. Yeah, you can see one of the things we're contending with up here. We have tons and tons of rocks, which is kind of nice for some things, I guess, for, you know, well, foundations and such, but in for raised beds made out of rocks. But yeah, we dug all those out of the ground, I think. In our gardening efforts. Oh, and then sometimes we hit rocks that are way, way too big to move. Like this entire surface here is actually a giant slab of bedrock. That's why we're building raised beds, to actually have something to grow in, because sometimes bedrock's only a couple inches down, like here. So this is going to be the log building yard until we get, and eventually it'll be like a driveway coming through this. I mean, we already kind of drive on this, so it's kind of already a driveway. But yeah, I pulled up all these logs from the bottom of our land this winter with the snowmobile, and 2 winters ago I got the rest of the other logs, and I think I finally have enough logs now with those and those and those over there to build our two-story sauna. I know it sounds ridiculous, but the top story is actually going to be guest quarters, and it's going to be like right there, kind of where that pile of logs is, and facing that direction, which is somewhat of a view, sort of southwest facing. Yeah, and that's the I don't know, lots of big plans, big dreams. What do you think? How's the view from up there, Jen? That's going to be like the view from the sauna. We're going to build the sauna right there.
top of me?
Well, no, you're not going to be there when we build it. I hope not. But anyway, yeah, our driveway will eventually like kind of wrap around this way and go back there. It'll be like a teardrop shape. There's the sawmill shed. I'm sure that everybody's thoroughly disoriented by now with all the waving around of the camera I'm doing. We ran into chipper shredder last year and made a bunch of piles of mulch. There's one. There's one. There was two over there, right there and there. And yeah, this is a compost, our new composting system. Log cabin composting with small poles. That's what those poles are for. So yeah, we'll continue along our driveway. Kids, be careful on there, okay? I'm going back to the house. Yep, I'm going back to the house right now. So, anyway, yeah, this is the, I don't know, that's pretty much the whole tour, I guess. Most of the snow is gone. Almost all of the snow is gone. We've actually been landlocked for 2.5 weeks now. It's not enough snow to snowmobile up and down the road, and too much snow on the road, and too much frost and muck to drive up. So here's our snowmobiles parked for the summer. And yeah, since the road, all the snow's gone up here, but since the road is compacted snow, very, very compacted snow, and a lot of part of it's in the shade, it's actually, there still is some snow and ice on the road. And as you can see right over here in the shady areas of the bog, there's also still some snow, more snow back in there. Did hear the frogs for the first time last night though, so that's promising. But anyway, this is the magical little cedar grove, which is just this really cool little spot that was naturally like brush free. And check this out, this is really cool, if I can find it. This is like somebody cut into this tree with an axe. I don't know if you can see, but there's clearly axe marks on this tree. Actually down here first, you can really see clearly that it's from an axe there. And so that's like, I don't know if you can see that, but somebody must have done that with an axe like 100 years ago. And then like the tree was like probably like a lot smaller then, obviously. And I think that they cut through down here and saw that it had heart rot, and they stopped, and they cut through up here and saw that it had heart rot, and then they stopped again. And this tree is just like slowly growing around it. So it's, I don't know, that's just really cool. I've actually seen several of those like that up around on our property and elsewhere in the area. But yeah, cedars are pretty resilient. That one's still alive. So the cedars grow really slow around here. Most of those that I was cutting over there are like 12 to 14 inches the butt, and they're over 100 years old. So this one's about, I don't know, 20 inches or so.
Come over here.
Okay, now Jen's going to show us. What are you going to show us now? Oh, there's the chickens.
The trampoline. I want to start on the trampoline.
Oh, yeah. Did I forget? Oh, I forgot the garden space is over there. Yeah. And there's the bone tree. Okay, here's the trampoline. Okay. Do I need to go on the trampoline for part of the tour?
Yeah.
Boom. 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 Oh, man. I think I'm going to make people nauseous if I put this video on the internet. Okay. So, yeah, one more thing to see, and then the end of this incredibly long, probably really boring tour. Here's the other side of that garden I was talking about at the beginning of the tour. Yeah, the tool kitchen, everybody's seen that, but in case they haven't, another big giant water barrel. The tool kitchen, the workshop, super crappy, second thing I ever built here. Can't wait to tear it down, but it's going to be a little while. Right now it serves as a perfectly functional workshop space with a pallet floor and partly dirt floor. And that's where our batteries are and the inverter and the charge controller. It's like the magic behind our solar system. And you found a cool rock. Awesome, Jen. Yeah. And there's tools and stuff everywhere as usual. There's our little generator shed thing. And that's the tool trailer, which has tons and tons of extra junk and hardware in it. It's somewhat organized, and I don't have to go to the hardware store very often. And here's our other raised beds. There's a raised bed. there's another there's our solar panels. There's another water catchment thing. And
Daddy.
Yeah, more raised beds. And then I'm just tilling up this area for strawberries here.
You put
God, tilling is some hard work. We dug up.
You should put this in your rock collection.
You can put it in the rock collection.
You
can go put it in the rock collection, sure.
Where is it?
Right over there.
Where?
Right over there.
Oh, yeah.
By the trailer. I dug out in this space, which is about 6 feet by 30 feet, I think. I dug out that bucket of rocks and those rocks and that bucket of rocks and those rocks and those rocks and that bucket of rocks and those rocks and that bucket and that bucket and that bucket. And those rocks, all from this space here. And I'm not digging like super deep. I'm digging like a foot and a half maybe. That's the kind of soil we have around here. So that's what we're competing with. It's actually my least favorite thing to do out here on the homestead is break new soil, but you gotta grow food somehow, I suppose. So I know that rock is really pretty, isn't it? You can see why that one's in my rock collection, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah, and here's our summer hand wash station. Yeah, got just a little drain there going hose thing to this compost pile over there. Yep, and back to the chicken coop and another raised bed. Yep, that pretty much concludes the tour. I don't know. What do you think, Jen? Did we forget anything? We forgot the... Oh, yeah, okay. Well, people have already seen this, but there's the crappy Finlander bus trailer that was free. And there's the guest trailer that we let friends and interns stay in. And here's the crappy building I got for free, and it almost collapsed coming up the road, and almost collapsed under snow a year later, but now it's somewhat reinforced. There's what we tried to plow the road with for a while. Kind of works up to about 2 feet of snow. And here's the fire pit, and then back to the sawmill shed, and we're kind of on the driveway teardrop thingy I was talking about.
Daddy,
oh, we could go on and on, but I probably shouldn't. What did I forget?
The garden stake.
The garden stakes?
Yeah.
I think we already saw the garden a couple times, actually.
Yeah, we did.
And it is a beautiful, beautiful early May afternoon.
Can we go and take another tour of the... can I show you a cool...
You know what? I'm going to let you record a tour now, Jen.
Okay.
Yeah, just a minute. Let me... Okay. I'm going to let Genevieve record a tour now, so we'll see you later, and hope you enjoyed this incredibly long, probably boring tour. All right. Bye. Taking a video. Just don't push any buttons.
Okay. Here's the trampoline again. Hi, Gaga. What's up, Gaga? Hi, Gaga. Hi, Gaga. Hi. Hi, Gaga. Hi. Hi. What's up? What are you doing?
I'm about to hit the camera, dude.
What are you doing, Gaga?
I'm doing this.
What are you doing? Being a tree? Are you banging a tree?
Yeah.
That's a silly idea to do. Okay. So, here's the big trampoline. Or here's the little trampoline, I mean. Okay, I'll show you how I jump on it. Okay?
Do not drop the camera, Jen.
I won't. Okay, so here's a little trampoline. And here's my butterfly net that I use for crickets, grasshoppers, and other stuff like that. Okay, so here's Gallagher's bucket that he always keeps wanting me to take away from him. Okay, so here's a sled that I slide on the slide. And, okay, so there's the big trampoline. Right up ahead. I'm going there. To jump on there and still show you a video, a tour.
It's recording now. I think it's upside down though.
Okay. Ah! When I was turning it the right way, now look what happened.
You pushed something.
Yeah.
If you push the screen or buttons or anything, you push this button here.
Which button?